Okay, so look, if you have glasses out there, this is a good time to raise them up. Two-part toast. I'm going to start. I'm going to let my big fella finish. But I want to say honestly, from the bottom of my heart, I know I speak for myself, our cast, our team, you guys being here means the world. You guys honestly enjoying yourself here makes it an amazing experience for all parties involved. So I just want to say, it's heartfelt. This toast is to you guys and your participation in our film, man. Please enjoy. Enjoy it.
Guys, Kevin said it all, but truly, thank you for joining us. This has been a labor of love for us, and so it is such an honor and a thrill for all of us to share it with you. So with that, we are officially kicking off our Jumanji press junket. So come and have a drink with our Jumanji cast. Yes. Cheers, everyone.
It does feel to me like we have a magical chemistry. I love my cast mates. I consider them good friends. And I think that's important. I think that translates to good chemistry on screen as well. You know what it's all about with Jumanji? It's about big laughs and big action. And I think we brought it even more intensely this time than last time. Funnier bits and incredibly big action sequences. We got some scary, good special effects and like action with mandrills. These are man-eating monkeys. We got killer ostriches. Man-eating ostriches. Good times, man. And Danny DeVito and Danny Glover kicking out the jams. And don't forget about Awkwafina. So funny and awesome. We got an incredible cast. Come check it out.
We're going to see many different environments. So we start off in the jungle, but then we venture to other levels, and it's all brand new. We end up in the desert, and we have to ride some camels, and we end up actually on snow-capped mountains, which is a complete, that's like the antithesis of where we started in the jungle. It's just so different. And we get some new outfits for the winter weather, which I'm excited about. If I'm being totally honest, like, we don't really even, it doesn't really shift from before action and after someone shouted action. Like, it's pretty consistent. Like, even doing interviews, it's so funny because we don't even notice when the cameras have started rolling. Like, these guys are so funny. And they relentlessly make fun of me in the best possible way and kind of like a brotherly... I don't have any brothers, but now I know what it feels like to have them. And it's just so much fun. This is the most fun job ever. So, yes, Awkwafina we have, who is... I'm such a fan of her. She's so brilliantly funny. I've watched her videos on YouTube and her other performances, and she is, I mean, just comedic gold. And so we really needed... basically another female in the movie who could really like deliver on that front, and she more than does that. She's a perfect addition to this core cast, and I'm just excited to have another girl around. And then the two Dannys, I mean, what legends. They're so amazing, and we're all just sort of in awe of them when they're on set. It's like, oh, the Dannys are here. Like, we need to be on our best behavior and learn something from them. Audiences can look forward to brand new characters. We have brand new players. We have two old men trapped in a video game, which is just so funny. We've got Fridge trapped in Jack's body now, so he's just flailing around dealing with that. And because I'm the only original player in their original avatar, I kind of have to step up and be the leader of the gang. And so we see Martha, this shy girl from the last movie, completely leading the charge, which is really cool compared to how she started off.
Right now we're in Cabo, and we're kicking off the Jumanji press junket, Jumanji the next level, and it's a lot of fun. We just had a toast over there on the bridge, and very happy to be here. Well, you know, I mean, it's an interesting thing. I really love them a lot, and I think you know, I'm the newest member of the Jumanji world, and I remember watching the first one and being like a total fangirl. So when I came onto set, I was nervous, but they definitely embraced me, and the chemistry that you see is definitely on and off camera. They're my dude. Jake had a really clear vision, and he's passionate, and I think that, you know, from the first meeting I had to talk about the character of Ming, I could definitely tell that about him. And, you know, we were just in a press conference talking about the aspect of trust, and I think that it was, you can't help but really know that Jake is going to guide us in a good direction, because he cares about the material, he cares about the stories and every character he thinks out, and it's seriously an honor. Jumanji has always been a phenomena for me. When I was a kid, I watched the first movie and I was obsessed with it, and I making this movie, I would look back on that obsession, and I think it's because everybody wants to feel like a hero. Everyone wants to take a risk, and everyone wants to escape. And I think that in the world of Jumanji, anything is possible. And I think that the audiences that we saw here at this junket are so, they love it so much. They feel good, and that's how you feel making it and watching it. So go see it.